Thank you. you all for coming. This is the Nathan Hubbard Trio. This is Kevin Jones on the guitar. Craig Mancino on the bass. Kevin moved to, was it 5 years?
4 or 5 years ago.
Okay, 5 years ago, Kevin moved across the country, and we've been crying and weeping since then. But we played a bunch previous to that, and right before he left, we made a record in 2019. And then I got him to come out this year, and we just tracked another record, which we're putting out, and we're playing most of the music tonight. It's available digitally, and then there'll be CDs in a couple weeks. On rare occasions, some of you still know what CDs are. So we're going to be playing. That first tune was called...
Hey, there we go.
Start up.
Hi, I'm Nathan. How are you guys doing tonight? Thank you for coming. Kevin Jones on the guitar. Hi, I'm Mancino on the bass. We are excited to play some new music that we recorded in August and we're releasing. This record is called Seeds of Rivers. That first tune was called Second Spring. I know we're in like third summer right now, right? So people from San Diego know about the Second Spring. The next tune is called Reoccurring Dream Space. It was sort of written from a comment that Wayne Shorter made. Thank you. said, we're playing a bunch of new music. We have a dedication. This doesn't happen very often, but I've been asked to dedicate to Robin from Daniel for an extra special night, since she's so special to him. We're going to play a tune that kind of fits into that. This is a sort of a ballad. Tristan, it is a jazz ballad. Normally, we play this a few times, and Leonard Patton, who runs this place, co-runs it with his wife, sings this, but unfortunately, he's off doing theater. So we're going to play it instrumentally. It's called Stay Too Long at the Fair. Thank you.
bunch of different records over the years. Some of them being very avant-garde, some of them dealing with hip-hop or beats or different things like that. So I thought, okay, we're gonna, it was actually my wife said, you know, you should just do a trio record. And we wouldn't expect that. Four double CDs. Who does that? Two of them with large ensembles of like 50 people. So she was like, yeah, you should just do a trio. Because nobody would think he would actually do that. So we did that, this stream, kind of focusing on a certain stream of playing. And then I thought it was going to be extra cool. I'll write the title track for the record, but put it on the second record. And then, wait, you said there's actually a name for this?
It's kind of wrong. Eponymous means an eponymous record, I think, is the name of the record that shares the name of the band or something like that.
And I thought I was being cool.
And
what did Spinal Tap say? So close from stupid and ridiculous or something? Anyways, so that was this stream. We're going to keep playing this tune. What is this one? Oh, Encinitas Unknown. This title's still kind of... I'm a little bit of a shy guy, so this title is kind of funny. Anyways, here we go. Thank you.
given.
Harley's been putting up with my ish for probably over 20 years. Let's give a hand to Harley.
Okay.
Thank you.
Criticism in San Diego in the last 10 years. You've heard the name Robert Bush. He wrote for the San Diego Reader. He's been writing for the Troubadour a little bit. He was one of the few people in town that regularly wrote about jazz, championed all sorts of people. He passed 3 weeks ago. He was, I think we were friends. I loved Robert. He could get a little dark, but I really enjoyed spending time with him. He actually wrote probably about me more than anybody else in San Diego, and I appreciated that. The last time we talked, he asked if I had these Jack DeJohnette records. We talked about Jack a lot, and I didn't have them on CD, so I bought the CDs. I knew what he wanted to talk about, so I bought the CDs and went over and hung with him, and he told me what was going on. And he told me this story about seeing DeJohnette with his New Direction band with Lester Bowie and Abercrombie. Anyways, at the stage door in San Diego State. He's told me this story a few times about how at the end of the concert, Jack came out and played that tune just on the piano. And he told me multiple times that he memorized the melody and he sang it to himself the whole way home. And it wasn't until like a year later, the record came out. He was like, "Ah, that's that tune." So, anyways, that tune was for Robert. We're going to do one more quick dedication. Our friend Nina Deering passed away a few years ago. I played a bunch of music, recorded a bunch of music with her, and one of the songs that I wrote for her to sing that I never got a recording of, we're going to play. It's called "After First Rain." This actually requires audience participation. I'm serious. Who? Like this. I know Michael Till can. Come on, grab one. Come on, come on. This is fun.
Gary, you get the weird one. This one's beautiful and shimmery.
Yeah, thanks for that one. There we go.
And then actually, since you're here, take another one.
Pass it over there somewhere.
This was sort of written to you. Maybe, you know, you wake up in the morning, it's kind of raining a little bit. I grew up in Encinitas, this is normal. I have a little melody playing, so we're going to play this all nice and gentle. Everybody ready? Let's hear it. Sound check. Here we go.
Jingle, jingle.
That was wonderful. What's next?
Oh, maybe.
Yeah. We're going to play one from the first record. I thank you all for... Original music doesn't get played a lot in this town, so being able to play an hour of my tunes is kind of a rare thing. I also remind you that this concert was going to happen at a different place, and the place went out of business. I'd like to thank Louis Valenzuela for making sure I knew about it and that he made this thing happen. I also want to thank Leonard Patton, Jerusa Patton, and everyone here at the Jazz Lounge for letting us do this here. It's kind of a last minute thing. I want to thank Kevin Jones for coming all the way out from Ithaca, New York. I want to thank Carly Maxino for being my favorite bass player. Top five. I mean, you can't play favorites because then other people just stop talking to you and get mad. Death threats. We're going to play a tune from the first record called Made It Out Alive. Thank you. title of Strangers with Shared Memories. It goes out to the guy I kicked out of my house that one time. You know, you get to that point with friends and you're like, we've been friends for 30 years and they have nothing in common except the fact we went to high school together.
New movie that's coming out.
Really?
That's similar to what you're saying.
Did they steal my title too?
No, that's not the title, but the idea.
Okay, good. I was going to have to, I can't afford a lawyer these days. I think everybody felt that during the shutdown, you realized. Okay. This last tune goes out to everybody. Thank you for coming. It's called Be Good to Your Demon Set. I have a few. This was the year I decided I was going to play catch up with COVID and I put out I think six records. They're over here in the box. Thank you all for coming. We'll see you soon. Have a good night.